Welcome back to Painting the Roses Red. It's Becky and Maybe. Hi guys, welcome back to the kitchen. Well, today I am going to make some tomatillo salsa, and I'm going to show you what I do with it after I get done. So these little guys are tomatillos, and it's part of the gooseberry family. They have this little papery skin on the outside. You peel them, give them a good wash, and then dump them in a pot of water. I have quite a few jalapenos because we really like our salsa spicy, and I don't remove the seeds until after they're cooked. Honestly, the only reason I remove the seeds is because I don't like to eat them. But I also put extra in because, again, we like it spicy. So if you don't, you can put as little or as much as you would like. So I'm going to give these a quick wash, dump them into this pot, and let them cook. We're going to cook them for between 10 and 15 minutes. Usually the shades of green will change. You can prick them with the tines of a fork and they will be fork tender, basically. So let's do that. So they are all scrubbed and in their little, actually bigger pot of water, because I misjudged with the amount of produce that we had, which I am just going to praise God and thank him for his abundance, and also thank him that this pot was available easily and we could just switch it out really quick. So guess what? Now we just turn it on, 10 to 15 minutes, let it boil. Don't forget to add some salt first, because water doesn't come salted and we want to make sure that our food has flavor. So we're going to let it cook and I'll see you in a minute. So here it is, bubbling away. And as you can see, the tomatillos have changed color. They have kind of a yellow color. They're not so green anymore. The chilies have started to change color just slightly. And you want them fairly soft. We are going to take the hull out of the tomatillos when we're done. We're going to take the stems off and the seeds in the middle, just because, again, I don't like to eat the seeds. Then we can process them a lot easier. I usually chop them before I throw them in, just because I really like a smoother type of salsa. I don't like the chunkier that much. Plus, when you do it a little bit smoother, it's a lot easier to incorporate into other recipes, which that's what part of this series is about. I'm going to show you how to make this salsa, but I'm also going to show you what I like to do with it. Everybody loves a really fantastic salsa with chips and topping a taco or whatever. But when you can actually use this in a recipe, to me, that is just stellar. So we need to give this a little bit more time, and then we're going to take care of them. So that's what we want. See that very dull, almost army green color that the jalapenos have changed to? Plus, the tomatillos have split, almost like they're letting their skin separate from the inside flesh. That is exactly what we want. They are fork tender. They're not like super mushy. You can use them super mushy if you want to, but I think this is the perfect texture for them, that way you can easily take the hull or the core out so that it processes a lot more smoothly. Isn't that amazing? I think they're just beautiful little things. So we can easily just take those stems off. We are going to take these out and put them in a strainer. Save the water for a little bit, because we can use that to thin it out a little bit if it gets a little bit too thick. But we're going to turn this off, let it cool a little bit, because I have asbestos fingers. Not everybody does. Want to make sure we're not burning ourselves here, okay? So we're going to take these out and let them sit for a little bit and cool so that we can de-seed them and take out the stems and things. And I'll see you in a minute. Look at bacon is already off for us. Woohoo! So here's my little setup. I have my cutting board. I have my little plastic tub so that I could put the jalapenos and the tomatillos in so I can get them one at a time. Remember, I do have asbestos hands, so touching hot things is really not that big of a deal. But if you have any trouble with that, if you are sensitive to peppers or things, you might want to put some gloves on while you're handling these, because remember, they are hot. Jalapenos can go from mild to fairly peppery, so again, you can change this recipe depending on how hot of a heat you want. We love it warm here, so we added a few extra. You can also use some tongs to hold on to them so that you're not burning yourself. Again, safety first, please, guys. So I sort of set this up assembly style. Just going to take a sharp knife and trim these off. I'm going to split them down the middle so it exposes the seeds, and I'll show you what I do to take those out pretty quickly. So as you can see, quick and easy, I just slice these open. I took the tops off. I wish you could smell this because they smell amazing. But as you can see, there's seed pods in there. And we want to just quickly, easily just remove those because, again, not that I don't want the heat, I actually don't want the seeds because they get stuck in my teeth and it's very uncomfortable. And they don't blend really well and just crush up and completely disintegrate. So I'm just going to really quick take a grapefruit spoon. Yeah, I said it. Grapefruit spoon. They have a serrated edge right at the tip. And that's how you can easily, quickly get into a grapefruit. Well, you can also use that to easily scrape the seeds right out. See, I'm not doing really any work at all, and I'm doing this one-handed, believe it or not. Really quickly, easily, just remove those seeds. You can actually remove the ribs as well if you like, and makes quick and easy work of that job. So that grapefruit spoon made it really simple and easy to just go through and get the seeds and most of the ribs out. And I'm just going to chop these up and then chunk them right into the blender cup, and we'll move on to the next step. So real quick and easy, I just chopped up the tomatillos, and I actually took the little holes out just because they're not so great to eat. And then chopped them up. We're going to put them in the blender jar, and I'm going to show you what I'm going to do next. So for some people, tomatillos have a very different flavor than a regular tomato. It's very, I don't know what the word is. I'm actually having a little bit of a hard time. It never really bothered me. I was really surprised. It's almost, I guess it's almost like an astringent type of flavor. It's very strong. And so sometimes it just needs to be given something to make it a little more mild and palatable. So because it has that strong flavor, I use cilantro to calm it down, which most people wouldn't think that it would calm it down, but it does. It gives it a really, really creamy, very green color. We absolutely love it in this house, and I hope that you try this combination. This is not the way that I was taught to make it, so yeah, we're taking a turn at Albuquerque. So we're going to plop this in. That's where the water comes in that you saved. You might need it to thin it out just a little bit. I am going to toss in some salt to taste along with some garlic powder or granulated garlic, whichever you have. And then we're going to mix this in the blender. So at this point, really, oh, there's a big old leaf in there. See that? So at this point, give it a taste. See if it needs more garlic, more salt, more cilantro. We actually still have some right there because it didn't all fit. Believe that. It actually looks pretty thick, so I'm going to give that a stir and see what we need to do next. So there you go. She's all set, nice and creamy and perfect for some chips or another recipe. Stay tuned because I'm going to show you a recipe next time. stay tuned because in the next episode, I'm going to share with you how I use this tomatillo salsa for a beloved recipe in our house. I hope you're having a very blessed day wherever you are, and I'll see you soon. Bye! I hope you're having a very blessed day wherever you are, and we'll see you soon. Bye!